spores.
Yo, what is up there, guys? It's InfestedMothership checking in, and we're playing some Desert Strike. That's right, one of the most popular games on the arcade. Always has been, probably always will be. I'm playing random, so I don't know which race I'm gonna get. I'm best with Protoss, so if I don't get Protoss, back off of me. You guys can be sometimes brutal on my playing abilities in these custom games, but I'll try my best. Just a random pub, so we'll see exactly how it goes. Just reading a little some of the stuff here. Some thank yous on here. You can go to, if you have any issues, go to dsturney.com. Huh. Apparently they have tournaments for Desert Strike, so if that's something you're interested in, you could probably check it out right there at dsturney.com. Recently, patch 2.1 came out, so for those of you who never have actually picked up StarCraft, now is your chance to hop on and play all the arcade games. Every single arcade game on StarCraft 2 is free to play, so if you just download the starter edition of StarCraft, you can hop on and start doing it. And also with the release of patch 2.1, you can play any race. You can't ladder. I think that's pretty much the only thing, and obviously you can't play the campaign without having bought the actual copy of StarCraft 2. Anyways, we're getting pretty close to loading up here, so there we go. All right, huge map. I actually have all my... Okay, cool, we got Terran. Let's see. Let's go with... You know what, we'll try with Expert Game, just because I don't want it to go onto crazy, massive unit spawns. That could lag my computer to hell. All right, I'm the last person to go, so I should definitely... get my gas then. First.
Not enough minerals.
Okay, saying rush. I'll let you go. Since I'm last. I'd say orange should probably be the aggressive one. He does go first. Alright, we need 800 minerals. So we'll stall my economy in trying to do this, but once it comes back up, it'll be it'll be higher than what it was before. There we go. Oh! Uh-oh! Someone used their boom already! Uh-oh. That's not good. You only get three of them. He killed three units, though. So... Nathan saying, wow. Might have a newbie. Ooh, we can zoom out. Oh! No bomb has left the game. Uh-oh. Reaper's moving across the map. And my economy's back. Oh, nice. Gonna decimate them zealots. And we're gonna start picking away at the silo. So, wow. And because they have their... Okay. This might be a very quick GG because we will probably get some extra cash once this goes down. Saying he doesn't get it. Neither do I. Let's see. If we can get some units out. No, I don't think I was able to. Wow, and the silo monster's out. So we already got 1,000 extra minerals. An incredible advantage this early on. Get some medics in here. Let's see what else. Vikings? Might be pretty good on the ground. A fast skirmisher. Use spider mines to attack enemy minis. Attack enemies and crosses the battlefield quickly. Does bonus damage to armored targets. That's good. That's a lot of zealots though. Pretty good counter push, but I think these reapers and marines are going to be able to take care of it pretty easily. Hellions? Yeah, let's get a couple Hellions.
Gotcha.
Nothing wrong with the Hellion.
Not enough minerals.
And, what else could we get? Actually, I'm digging the Vulture. Like me some Vultures. Are these my units? I don't know if they are. Maybe mine haven't come out yet. That's a lot of Marines. Yeah, let's go with the... No, okay, said I was gonna go Vulture, so let's go Vulture. Oh, no, I misplaced it. Uh-oh, our silo went down as well. Shoot. Well. Anyways, the economy's going to start coming back up. No, I still got some time, so I can build a couple more units. So you give me another medic.
Gotcha.
There we go. My units are the ones that spawn next, so we'll see how terrifying my force looks. AK Spartan saying, never go full Reaper. What type of game are we playing? Epic! Alright, here comes mine. Got some Vultures and Hellions. Oh, whoa, those Reapers have... Or those Dark Templars have like a jump charge ability. I thought it was 60 rounds. We'll have to see. forces doing an okay job. Those fire bats though at the front, pretty scary.
Not enough minerals.
I think expert got chosen though. Saying he's a bit drunk, that might explain his lack of perception. Alright, I'll try and get me some fire bats out as well, since fire bats seem to be doing so well. How do we build fire bats? Marines, ultra medic, yada yada yada. Where are... Adonde? Defensive bunker. Maybe you have to upgrade or something. Yes, you do.
Not enough minerals.
Okay. Well, that's unfortunate. Didn't think about reactors and stuff like that. Okay. Now that I know, well, I know. All right, so we can get predators, marauders, or fire bats. I want fire bats. Yay! So let's see. We're playing against what? A Terran and a Protoss. On our side, we have all Terran. We're a full Terran team. Oh man. We should try and work this out. So one player is going like, you know, certain things. The other one's going the other. But who wants to coordinate, really? Ooh, okay. EMP's gonna be nice. So let's go ahead and get some ghost out. Actually, are we coming up on our gas geyser? Yep. We are coming up on our gas geyser, so. Let's just prepare for that. There we go. Boom. Look at that. Goes through timing. And we're holding the line. So, in the end, taking down the silo wasn't actually totally useful, since apparently Reaper's not too good of units. Not the sickest of sickies. Alright, what else can we get? Ooh. We can get a transformation server, so we can get some hellbats if we want to try give mech a shot. I don't think I want to give mech a shot, though. Did I misplace that building? It looks a little misplaced. I think I did. Memory serves me correct. Alright. Our economy is going to be back online in 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1, liftoff! Yay! Okay. So we got a little extra cash in our pockets. Never a bad thing. Let's make our way towards the ever so. Actually, you know what? We're not going to get enough money, so that's what I'm going to do. Marauder there. And then maybe we can get. There we go. Just trying to get out as many units as I possibly can for this next wave. Actually, you know what? My wave's not looking too shabby at all. I thought it was going to be, you know, a little poor, but that's kind of hefty. Thankfully, we got some medics here to back up. Could do to have a few more. Actually, oh man, there's a cloaked banshee hanging out there. So let's, how do we get, I know there's like the flying little observatory thing. How do we get that though? How do we blink? You used to be able to blink. I guess you can't blink. Actually, hold up, my command key card is set to basic. This is what you should do. Enable simple. No, I want a complicated one, my friend. There we go. If you've never done that on your StarCraft client, you should definitely do that. It gives you access to a bit more options. Alright, so BG. No, VG. PVBGs. My wave spawn. You can see it right there. Oh, nice. Cannons. Oh, the EMPs. The EMPs decloaking the ghost. Sickness. Now we've got our own Banshee, look at that. I really don't know what the Spartan does, but we'll give it a shot. Build another. Oh, darn, I thought this was. Crap. My building micro. Not so good. Alright, let's build up to some tanks. Tanks? Pretty good.
Not enough.
Do you get to retain marine production? Yeah, okay, so you still make marines. Nice. So the added building is actually its own production facility in itself at a round. So you still get the marines from before. All it does is add on to your marine wave, which is pretty nice. Pretty nice, if I say so myself. That is a lot of DTs, though. Nice. There is an observatory. It's a monitor dirigible. Same thing, though. I mean, basically. The good thing about, even though our opponent's lost a teammate, that just means that they fill in for his wave. It's actually a slight advantage if they're good enough players, because then they don't have to actually rely on their enemy's craft. It's also kind of like that Nexus Wars, where if you lose a player, you get his extra income and his extra supply. So you can actually it's easier to upgrade. You spend less, as a team, you spend less money on upgrades, but because your income isn't really affected, you have a little extra cash. Can I land that over here? I can. Okay. Freeing up more space. Will do. Oh, no. Okay. Well, we'll just land it over here.
Unacceptable landing
zone. You're an unacceptable landing zone. Minerals. Not enough minerals. Yeah, I heard you. You never shut up, you know that? Maybe I never stopped clicking the key. By the way, I apologize for the extremely loud keyboard. You know how it is, guys. You're probably used to it by now, but I still always feel bad about it. It's quite obnoxious, I know. Let's go ahead and watch my wave. It's my awesome and spectacular wave. I also probably need some medevacs, because I don't think those are my medevacs in the back there. Those are somebody else's. They're on loan. Use them. Oh, nice. My siege tanks got set up, only to be overran by bio in just a moment. Oh, wow. Getting quite a few kills, though. The cool thing about siege tanks is once you start to get a lot of them, if you can keep them for a wave, they'll retain themselves because they'll generally stay in the back. So if you can... Sometimes your siege tanks will aid your allies' waves. Anyways, alright, I'm going to take a moment and change my graphics settings. There we go. Still not the greatest frame rate in this game just because of all of the amassing. But, alright, so... So, mech.
Roger.
There we go. So now we've got 4 siege tanks in total. That's a lot of hellbats. Look at that. I know you're jealous.
I'd be jealous too.
Alright. Can we stand up to the opposite Terran might? I think so. Right? EMP is going off. Some colossi. A bit terrifying. Will we hold though? That is the question. Medivacs being retained from the previous wave was pretty nice. Boost there. No, it looks like the siege tanks are gonna get taken out. Let's get some, after this wave, or after this upgrade. Actually, what can we get? Diamondbacks and Goliaths. It might be kind of good for... Nah. We'll get another extra bundle of siege tanks here, and then we'll start getting our own medevacs. Because that stim, man, it wears on you after a while. You know what? I don't remember what wave it is that this gets opened up at, but whoops, I didn't make anything. But fortunately, we have an extra Viking and an extra pair of siege tanks. There we go, siege tanks getting set up. And getting lifted back up again, too. Sprites do pretty good against the Colossi, they have really nice range, so that's one bonus to having this Spartan in on the mix, but it's only one. Oh, it's also pretty good against the medevac. Nice, look at the siege tank damage and so much damage. The bio doesn't know how to micro and run up on top of the siege tanks, but it doesn't look like it's going to matter too much. Alright, so let's get some medevacs here. Alright, we need a starport first. What else can we do? What is that? Raven's science vessels. Actually, we might want, to get battle cruisers at some point, but for now... Let's build this. Uh-oh, AK Spartan has left the game. Alright. Alright, well, we have an extra boom now. Don't know why he left, but... Oh, Widow Mines. Should get some Widow Mines, yep. Man. Nice. Anything else we can upgrade here? No, nothing too crazy. Look at that fat army, though. Who's is that? Looks like Mason's. Oh no, it's AK Spartans. Oh wait, no, it might have been Mathans. Yeah, it was Mathans. Alright, army away. Oh, is that mine? No. Okay, well this is AK Spartans, so yeah, that must have been my army. Oh, ooh, the Storms. This Protoss player, man. He's pretty good. Pretty scary army. Now this has to be... Who's this? This is mine? That's my army. I'm so confused on whose army that was. Doesn't matter because the frame rate is 6. Oh no, don't unsiege. Now you're just gonna re-siege. That's not good. Not good at all. Alright, let's work up to battlecruiser. Everyone wants the battlecruiser operation. Ugh. Lasers too much for this computer to handle. Unfortunately, I'm not on my awesome computer. That's why my microphone's a little bit of lower quality than it has been of recently. And also, yeah, kind of laggy. Oh man, I need to build some stuff too. Alright, battlecruiser is almost operational. How do we do this? Well, now the frame rate's back to 4. Hard to tell if it's a computer issue or if it's actual game optimization issue, but I mean, Desert Strike is a massive up sort of game, so it does happen from time to time. As long as we don't look at the fun and the battles and stuff, which is alright. So that's the Protoss army against the Terran Dominion. Wow. Terran right through. Ooh, but the Hellbats. Oh man, the Hellbats. Hellbats were a good decision, I think. Where are the Widow Mines? Oh, I see one. Nice, well at least they're around. That's the important part. We're starting to push over this hill. There's another full-blown army. Widow Mine's not really getting too much off. Sea Chank's getting some good shots fired. Okay, two battlecruisers. Not too much anti-air from our Protoss opponent. Oh, he's getting Void Rays though. Oh, so many Marines though. So many Marines. The battlecruisers though. Oh, the Raven putting up PDDs. Is that actually, what is that blocking right there? Was that blocking Marine shots? Not how that's supposed to work, but I'll take it. We got the better concave. We're starting to push though. We've been pushing pretty well. At least maintaining the center. Alright, let's see. Let's just build some barracks. Barracks seem to be pretty good, so take them. Should also probably follow his building design next time. Seems pretty efficient. Guy likes Marauders too. Can't blame him though. Marauders pretty good. They can weather the storm of storms. So I'll get some myself. We still have our boom. We still have 3 booms, which is one more than our opponents, which is an advantage that we have. One that we'll take. Okay, the battlecruisers in the back. A couple of actual flying Vikings, although I don't think those are mine. And my allies, and we're gonna be moving forward again. This is what I was talking about, where the siege tanks, if they can survive, they start to really help because they can survive multiple waves with their insane DPS. Alright, let's see. What do we want to build? I guess more battlecruisers. We don't really have that many, to be honest. Not enough minerals. No, I haven't gone full battlecruiser yet. Not enough minerals. And I'd like to go full battlecruiser. Not enough minerals. This will be the last one, I think. And then I gotta start saving some cash for the next gas. Not enough minerals. Oh, wait, can I? Nope, yep, I can already get my next gas. Started mine late, look at that, about 50 seconds later than Mathun, and then we did ours at the same exact time. I forgot that now that the wait times between waves have been increased, or the wait time for income restore has been increased, that it's not too much of a delay in between each wave. Add-on is complete. I wish the frame rate didn't suck, guys. Not too much I can do. I think you'd rather have a video than no video. Especially one as awesome as Desert Strike. Look at all this. This mayhem, this destruction. I get the same frame rate. Actually, I was getting worse frame rate back in my base. Kinda crazy. This Spider-Man, man. I should get some more vultures. I'm starting to litter the field a bit. I think I've only got, like, 2 vultures being built at a time. But imagine if we're building, like, 8 at a time. Each wave would be filled with Spider-Mans, man. Look at that. They do quite a bit of damage. I over-underestimate Spider-Mans. Can't wait until the final battle. Can you? Whoa, don't put your gear in the rear. Not enough minerals. That's just not how it was meant to be done. Once again, it's the Battle of the Bulge. Right on. Right in the middle of Desert Strike. Woohoo! Why is he so excited about overtime? He's a prisoner, so doesn't he work for free? Right? All Terrans are prisoners? Oh, I guess they originally were. Not anymore, though. Okay, and that's our final income wave. So at this point on, it's nothing but death and destruction. This Tempest They're staying alive. They are really doing work, but unfortunately, they're all targeting down Marines for them, so not totally effective. Now might be the time where I wonder if the Spartans would be better than the Vikings. Something to consider. I feel that Vikings are probably the correct answer. Those toughest, they're starting to reclaim ground. Making pushes. So many zealots. Protoss Edbo, of course. Albats. Holding the line. Zealots making on through. Have they gotten gas? I don't know. Do you think they skip or push? I don't play enough Desert Strike. To know. That's so many Tempests. Oh, I think they only did one. Is that going to be a problem? Could be. They do have a lot of Tempests, though. My god. How expensive are the Tempests in this game? Oh, nice. As long as we don't die. Anyways, my income is back, so that's some good news. Alright, what do we want to build? Vikings. Vikings are what I want to build. More Vikings. They have a lot of Vikings themselves. Battlecruisers turn out kind of terrible. Ooh. First. Who boom first? Boom last. Alright. Why'd you get stuck? That's not cool, man. Where's the Viking thing? The Viking Bay. Excuse me.
Not enough minerals.
A Fennel says he'd boom if we were him.
I can't build here.
Might be true. Might not. We'll have to see. You're screwed. LOL. No worries. I say. All for fun and games, of course. As everything is in the arcade. Oh, we get a boom! Why didn't you boom? Why no boom? No, well. Ah, like everything, I'm a failure. oh man. Anyways, guys, just a quick Desert Strike game. For those of you who made it to the end, you're true fans, and I definitely appreciate you. So I'm just gonna give this little heads up for you guys. Gonna be playing more Dragon RPG. I know I started it and then kind of quit it. My winter break was actually pretty hectic. I was putting out a ton of content for you guys. But I kind of got sidetracked. So I'm going to go back, continue Dragon RPG, because it's a great custom game. And I was in the middle of it. I was about to run through the infested area, which is apparently a pretty difficult zone. So I'm looking forward to that. Actually, you know what? I might go and play that right now. But as for that, InfestedMothership checking out. Thank you so much for watching. Peace. Hey there! Now, I know you enjoyed that video, and since you did, why not watch another one by clicking on the thumbnail below? And if you're feeling extra sweet, why not subscribe to my channel by clicking on the subscribe button as well? If you want to be a real pal, then you'll give the Facebook page a like and follow me on Twitter at SCMothership1 to get updated with all the cool news, events, and prizes. Thanks for listening, and like always, SCMothership checking out.